What's up, everybody? This is Mattia, and today I wanted to do a quick impression video about the DT700 Pro X. Now, I returned those headphones to Amazon, a little spoiler for what's coming in terms of the review, but there were some things that I really couldn't like at all about the headphone, while there were other things that kind of surprised me. Now, first of all, I want to make this video relatively short. It's not going to be one of those big, huge, massive reviews. But I wanted to mention, first of all, the fact that they were built like a fucking tank. Now, I know many people complained about the top headband, like kind of flaking, or even the glue itself detaching the fake leather part of the top piece, which is an occurrence that happens in between 5 to 10 months, depending on the user experience, but that's easily replaceable for about $10 to $12, about 10 euros in my case, and it's an annoyance. Of course, it's a studio headphone that it's meant to be thrown around in the studio, so it's meant to take quite a toll on itself. Because it's not something that audiophiles are supposed to use. You know, audiophiles take good care of their stuff. Studio, the people that are in the studio don't really give too much of a fuck because they need to get a job done and they need to do it fast and well. So they have to take something that can live up to a beating over the course of many, many years. And I think that the 700 Pro X is a very good headphone for that. It's basically a tank. The only problem that I found was the clamp force and the distribution of the pressure around my ears. Why is that? Since they have round ear pads, I find that they put most pressure on the front of my lobe and the back. Now, my ears didn't really touch the driver, but the issue was that there was so much pressure on my head that I even tried to loosen them up by like stretching them even over a few books, but that didn't really solve the issue of having like two hotspots right here and on the back of my ear, which caused a lot of discomfort even after 30 minutes. Now, the pads themselves are extremely comfortable. They're like soft, supple, and they're like this kind of velour suede material, which is incredibly soft. Frankly, they're the best ear pads I've ever touched. But the problem is that they don't have enough cup swivel and they have too much clamp force, so that they, in the long run, or in my case, in the short run, cause a lot of pain. And I think that if you're accustomed to the DT 880, 1990, 770 Pro editions, you can kind of get used to it. But when comparing this headphone to something like the HD600s, which have a shit ton of clamp pressure, even more than these, the Sennheisers felt much, much more comfortable because they managed to spread out the pressure applied on the head in a much better way. And they also have oval pads, which fit my ears much, much better. Now, the other thing that I want to mention with the build, let's say more on the drivability side, they're super easy to drive. I could drive them off a small dongle deck, the Tempotec Sonata BHD, not the Pro model, but the old model, with the 75 milliwatt input on high gain. They were getting extra super loud, which was too much, honestly, and I could easily drive them off of my computer. Not on my phone, because my phone has an especially low power output, so it doesn't really work that well. And yeah, they were super easy to drive, but really didn't experience any graininess or a lack of dynamism in with a lower output source. And they didn't really sound better off of an amp, so yeah. They're good anyways, wherever you put them. They're not a very peaky headphone. Now, regarding the sound, like, that's the most important part, I found that they're kind of boring. They're kind of muddy. They lack, and they lack like surface details. The ends of the trailing tones are blunted. They aren't like when the note finishes, it shouldn't end up with a crystalline presence. But on these, it just kind of rolls off. And that makes me think that the dampening on top of the driver makes it so that some details are masked. In fact, I could hear much, much, much finer details with my $100 Edimotic ER2 SE, which in itself is an extremely good IM for that kind of price. But it surprised me the fact that the DT700 Pro X lacked so much behind in terms of detail to the Edimotic ER2 SE, which, you know, was kind of a delusion. You know, I paid 245 euros for the headphones, and I should have expected a little more on the top end specifically. One thing that's particularly lacked on these headphones was the air. They felt boxy and compressed. Now, granted, the bass did make up for a lot of the, you know, a lot of the things that were actually missing. It was thumpy, clear. It kind of bled to the mids, into the mids a little bit, but it was very impactful and pretty engaging. The thing that set these headphones back for me the most, though, was the mid-range. It was sucked in, vocals didn't really shine through, and imaging was pretty average, as such was the soundstage. They were a little bit wider than the HD600s, but the HD600s, despite having a little closer-ring feeling and a little bit of a three-blob soundstage, the 700 Pro X managed to space out things a little bit better. I find that the 600 is so much more detailed that it's not even close, really, in terms of separation. The 700 Pro X sounds like you put everything into a mix, which I think is a very, very nice presentation for mixers, for studio users, but not for audiophiles. I find that I concur extremely with the review that DMS made on both the 700 Pro X and the 900 Pro X. Granted, I did not hear the 900 Pro X, but I do find that these headphones, the 700 Pro X, are not for audiophiles. They're not detailed enough. They're not engaging enough. They don't have enough upper treble detail to keep you truly like, oh my god, if you know what I'm saying. When I switch from the 700 Pro X and I go to my Edimotic ER2 SE, immediately the shift from a boomier, boxier sound to a more open, much more crystalline, much more detailed sound makes me think they are really not worthy for $245 for, critical listening. Now, granted, if you're mixing, if you need something sturdy, if you need something compact, relatively compact, they're not super huge headphones. I think the 600s are bulkier than those. But if you want something durable for the course of many, many years, and that is flat enough for mixing, then go for it. Fucking go for it. They're built like a fucking tank, and you can power them off anything, and they sound decent enough to be listenable for a, I don't want to say an audiophile, because some people might get offended, but for the average listener, they're good enough. The thing that I want to say is that they're not terrible. They're not even bad. They're pretty okay, actually. But if you want an audiophile sound, something that you can enjoy, like truly find the details in the mix, like you kinda listen critically to the music, that you want to hear what's in it, you want to hear the minute particularities that are in the music, then I will recommend something like the 666. Or the 58X Jubilees, even though the 58X doesn't really sound as good as the 666, or the Hyphaman Sundara, which is more detailed than the 700 Pro X. And yeah, that's it for the review. I think that, again, for producers, for mixers, they're good, but audiophiles that want something more from their music, I don't think they should be going this way. I think they should be selecting something that has more detailed, a little bit more soundstage, sounds a little bit sharper, because I'm treble sensitive actually, but these sounded so... I don't want to say wrong in the treble, because they don't sound wrong. They sounded kinda like constrained, and I think that's strictly correlatable to the fact that there's a fucking giant pad in front of the driver, which they used, of course, to tame the treble peaks that were in the 770 Pro 80 ohm edition, I think. I don't know if the 250 ohm had it, but the 80 ohm surely as fuck has it. So that's it for the review. I appreciate you watching it, and you know, of course, sorry for the video quality, but the thing that I managed to do is upgrade my camera. I have a better phone now, and that's it. So see you in the next one. Thank you, guys.